There are at least 7 different ways to take a screenshot in Windows 11, and today I'm going to show you how to do them all. If you've used Windows 10, many of these screenshot methods may sound familiar to you, since they're all basically the same in Windows 11. So if you haven't started using Windows 11 yet, you can still practice these tips on your Windows 10 machine. You know what else has stayed the same? The like and subscribe buttons on the YouTube player. I'll give you a moment to make use of them right now. Okay, first up, let's get to know the print screen button. Normally you'll find it right here next to the home button, but depending on your keyboard, it might say print screen or pert skn, or on my laptop here, just pert sk. What happens if I press it? It looks like nothing happens. That's because print screen by itself saves a picture of your whole desktop to the clipboard. If I open a program like Paint or Word, I can paste the image into my document and edit to my heart's delight. That's fine if you want to use the image right away, but what if you want to save it for later instead? Let's try the Windows button plus print screen. The screen will dim for a second to let you know a screenshot was taken, but you have to go to your Pictures folder, then Screenshots to see the saved file. To take a screenshot of just the active window and not the entire desktop, press Alt plus print screen. This will also copy the image to the clipboard, which you can then paste into another program to edit. Okay now, if the Windows key saves the image, and Alt takes a picture of just the active window, do you think that Alt plus Windows plus print screen would save just the window to the screenshots folder? Almost. This says the screenshot was saved, but then wants us to hit Windows G to open the Xbox game bar. And look at that, here it is in this other gallery. We can click the button here to see where it lives on our drive. And here it is in the Videos folder under Captures, rather than Pictures, but it did save just that window. So technically it worked. I haven't used the game bar a lot myself, but it has a lot of tools for gamers and streamers, including the ability to record video of your screen, not just a still picture. I'll have to look at this more later on, but I can press Windows G again to hide the game bar controls. I think that's about 5 different ways to capture your screen so far. Let's take a look at a couple more built-in apps that give you a lot more control over what you're capturing. We'll start with the Snipping Tool, which you can find by searching for it. When it opens, the first thing you'll see is there's another tool called Snip and Sketch. We'll get to that in a minute. Here under the Mode tab, there are 4 different options. Full Screen Snip and Window Snip, which do what you'd expect. Plus we have Rectangular Snip, allowing you to select just a section of your screen. And Freeform Snip, for those of you who hate right angles and would prefer to freehand your selection. You can also choose a delay if you need to position something on the screen, like a menu. From here, you can mark up your image using a pen tool or a highlighter. You can save the snip, copy it to paste it into another doc, or send it to someone via email. But let's get back to the Snip and Sketch app. As we can see here, this handy shortcut is the easiest way to get to the tool. Windows Shift S. These icons are the same as the one in the Snipping Tool. Rectangular, Freeform, Window, and Full Screen. This notification comes up to let you know it's been copied to your clipboard, and you can click here to share and mark up the image. Snip and Sketch offers more robust markup tools and more options for sharing after you've finished editing. To start over and grab something else, just press New to get back to your mode options. Or press X to close the app and get on with your life. So that's at least 7 different ways to take a screenshot in Windows 11. Or Windows 10 for that matter. But did I miss any? Let me know in the comments below, and while you're there, tell us if there are any other Windows 11 tips you want us to cover down the road. But nothing too hard, okay? Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.